Hello and welcome to this vlog for the 62nd auction here at Scotch Whiskey Auctions. Once again, Big Peatrie just lined up to give you a brief overview of some of the stellar bottles that we have in this month's auction. This month we are once again blown away by the depth of quality of whiskey that we have in the auction. We have over 3,000 lots in this auction, and many of them are wonderful old whiskies. For example, we've got nearly 100 lots where the whiskey in it was distilled in the 1960s. There's a wonderful range from the 1950s and all the way back to the 1919 and possibly a little earlier. It is a truly wonderful selection of whiskey in this month's auction. So please, as the recommendation always is, take some time when we go live tomorrow. Get in, have a look at, pour yourself a drink. Take some time out of your lives just to indulge yourself in the world that is wonderful, wonderful whiskey. So let's, without further ado, get on with these wonderful whiskies. Now first up is something that is very exciting to me personally because I'm a massive fan of this distillery. It's a wonderful old bottle of Springbank. And this one here was distilled in 1919. And it was bottled when it was 50 years old, and it was bottled, quite interestingly, at 66.3 degrees proof. Now that works out at 37.8 ABV. Now we have, as part of this lot, a letter from the seller to the buyer, guaranteeing that it's 50 years old, that it is underproof. It is a wonderful piece. We keep saying this phrase, liquid history. This is a wonderful bottle from an era way back, from one of the most iconic, idiosyncratic distilleries out there. And yeah, a highlight of, I'll be honest, since I've started working here, this is probably my favourite bottle that we've had in. I'm absolutely in love with it. A cracking, cracking bottle. Next up, we have another wonderful bottle, this time hailing from 1922, and this is a White Horse. White Horse is well sought after because of its use of Lagavulin old whiskies. Malt mill may or may not be in the mix in this. Wonderful old whiskey, driven cork, and a chance to do, again, it's just a chance to taste these blends, if you are going to open it, of a style and a nature that just isn't produced these days. The idiosyncratic use of direct fire, the way the casks were used at that point, is entirely, entirely different. Next up, we have a very interesting lot called the Borderer's Blend, which then goes on to call itself Fine Old Malt Whiskey. This is from the Border Brewing Limited, who were a brewery, but also a wine and spirits buyer. Now, what's interesting about this one is it bears the hallmarks of whiskey bottled at the start of the 20th century. There's no ABV, there's no proof, there's no information as to bottle size. It's a wonderful moulded three-piece bottle. It has a driven cork, much like the White Horse here. So we think it's in a similar kind of era. Now the company itself changed its name in 1925, so we know that it's pre-1925. What we have here is a trademark, which we know is being used as early as 1909. So that gives us a nice kind of era in which this whiskey comes from. Wonderful whiskey that will hopefully be opened by somebody who wants to explore the vagaries and the history of whiskey, or be looked after as a lot for future generations. Next up, we have three bottles. Now these three bottles are not one lot, they are in fact three separate lots, but they are all bottled by the same independent bottler. It's a Strathyle, 47-year-old, with the Book of Kells label on the front. And then we have a Glenlivet from 1938 and a Linkwood from 1939. These wonderful pre-Second World War whiskies were all bottled by Gordon MacPhail. Now, Gordon MacPhail is a name that comes up in the vlog all the time. You'll see it all the way through the auction. They're not a distiller, although they weren't a distiller at this point. Although they are a distiller now, owning Ben Romach Distillery. And we bring them up time and time again, and there's a reason for that. They are incredibly, incredibly linked to the success of Scotch whisky and single malt whisky as a product for consumption. But way back, that was 121 years ago, almost to the day, or 2 days after their birthday, they were founded in Elgin. Now, working for them at that point was a 15-year-old lad called John Urquhart. He was a capable and very useful boy, and he very quickly ended up becoming the person who was running the company. They kept the name Gordon MacPhail and have them for 121 years. But what was really important about them is that they were incredibly active in the bottling and the buying of single malt whiskey. Blended whiskey was the thing at that time. Blends were where it was. Single malt was considered too rough. It wasn't considered a good product in the same way. But they had the foresight to start bottling, especially early in the 1940s and the 30s. And so when the Second World War happened, when the consumption pulled back, they were able to keep their stocks. And towards the end of the Second World War, in the 1940s, they were able to sell some of their stocks to America to bring dollars in. They've been bottling incredible whiskey from then on. They have bottled the oldest single malt whiskies ever bottled, 1970s Mortlach, which you've seen in the auction, 1970s Glenlivet, and the 1975 Mortlach. A company without which the face of Scotch whiskey, as we see at the moment, would not be the same. Incredibly important company, responsible for bottling these incredible whiskies. And I've never been there myself, but I believe their bonded warehouse in Elgin is truly a thing to behold. Next up, another company, another is owned by a private family, and this is the Grand family. And this bottle here is a Hazelwood Reserve. Now this is one that was bottled for Janet Sheed Roberts' 90th birthday. It's a blending of 90 casks, bottled at 90 proof. And this was given out to friends and to family, and this bottle here was personally given to the seller by Janet Sheed Roberts. It was never available to buy, and it makes it quite, for a distillery company like the Grant family, who own Balvenie, Glenfiddich, they produce Grants, the whiskey is everywhere. This is a very limited release from that company. And a wonderful textual aspect to it, the fact that it was hand-given to somebody, it was a private offering. Next up, we have a wonderful bottle from the 1960s. As I said, we have nearly 100 lots that were distilled in the 1960s in this auction. And this one here was Beaumont, and it's been bottled for the Prestonfield Hotel. Now the great thing about this, other than it being apparently truly phenomenal whiskey, is that Andrew Symington, I can't remember how to pronounce his name, he was the manager of Prestonfield Hotel and went on to found the Signatory Bottling Company, who now own Edradour Distillery. So this bottlings that they were doing for the distillery, for the hotel, sorry, led him into an interest in whiskey, led him to found his own company, to then now owning a distillery. And this was one of the early bottlings that he did. Next up, we have a bottle from Balvenie. This is the Balvenie Tun Batch 1. Now this is part of the complete lot of the Tun 1401 series. The first time that this has ever been up at auction as a set. Again from the Grant family. Great whiskies that have created a phenomenal reputation due to its incredible quality, the vatting of these malts, and just a wonderful exercise in production of whiskey. Now last, but by no means least, we have a 50-year-old whiskey because, you know, if you're going to have a last one, why not let it be 50 years old? And why not let it be Glenfarclas? That wonderful, another distillery that once again allows you to just steamroller out these wonderful, rare, aged whiskies. That this one here was bottled to mark the 200th bicentenary of the birth of John Grant. So this wonderful whiskey here, bottle number 65 of only 110 bottles released, commemorates another great whiskey visionary. So that's the bottles we've chosen for the vlog this auction. But I really can't stress enough how deep, how wonderful the quality is in this auction. So, ladies and gentlemen, Big Peatrie once again telling you, don't lose your bottle, get in, have a look around, and just enjoy this month's auction. Cheers, bye-bye.